So tonight I have a group reading here on Long Island.
Ah, I got attacked by the plant.
Bottom line, with a group reading, I never know where I'm gonna start, who I'm gonna start with.
Hello, everybody. How are you?
I just put it in Spirit's hands. They just guide me where I need to be.
We're gonna need blotting pads tonight because I'm sweating. Between the metapause and the lights, I'm done. Anyway. Is your mom departed? Who is the AN name? Anthony?
I'm Andrew.
Oh, Andrew. Oh, perfect. Did you have a dream? You're the husband, is that correct? You lost your wife?
Yes, I did.
So did you just have a dream of her, or did you actually feel her when you slept? Because she said, please tell my husband that was me.
My name is Joe. I met Jacqueline when I was about 24 years old. We fell in love right away. From the minute she walked in the room, she just lit up that entire room. Everybody knew when she came in, everybody loved her, and she was just an amazing person.
So, I'm gonna ask you an odd question. Did your wife watch my show?
Yeah.
Cause she goes, tell him that I know that this is really real. He's getting it now, Teresa, because I used to watch it. He's going, I ain't watching that. Or he'd peek in and watch.
It's true, I would peek
now
in.
Now I watch it.
It was cool to see Teresa talk about how my mom watched the show, because it was true. I used to sit next to my mom watch the show, and it meant a lot that she knew that my mom, like, knows who Teresa is and knows about Teresa and everything she does.
Did she pass from an illness?
Yes.
She made me feel like that there were these ups and downs. Do you understand that? And then you ever watch the show The Price is Right with the mountain climber? When he gets to the top, that's my semaphore where someone's doing well, right?
She's doing fine.
Fabulous, she was doing great. We thought we'd made all those hurdles. This is the best she's been in years, correct?
Yep.
And then all of a sudden, she died.
My wife Jacqueline suffered from bipolar depression. It happened later on in her life, and our children were growing up as it happened.
There was times of extreme happiness and extreme sadness. To the outside world, you would think that everything was fine. But it wasn't really fine at all. My mom was really sick.
But I had to sit next to my mom and like, tell the doctor he's not okay, but he didn't believe me. And I felt like it was my fault because
Your fault. How could that be your fault? Your mom said, I chose to stop taking my medication, correct? You had that conversation with her, correct?
I did.
She goes, I told you I couldn't do this anymore. I don't want to take these medications. I want to feel normal.
She says, I can't do this much more.
She says, I take full responsibility for my choices. Do you understand that?
Yes. I could tell that she was at her wit's end, that it was just getting too much for her. Jacqueline left for an appointment, and I was waiting for her to come home. And as the afternoon started to grow, I realized that it's not like Jacqueline to be away from the house for that long. My wife, Jacqueline, took her own life on our 22nd wedding anniversary.
She knows of all of your dreams and who you want to be. You say, how am I going to get married without my mom? How am I going to do this without her? She says, I don't want you to stop living your dreams because of my death. And she said, and I want to thank each and every one of you for loving and honoring me the way that I deserve to be and accepting me for who I was, but more importantly, for who I couldn't be at times.
For my children to feel that Jackie is with them at every point of their life, I just think is a burden that's just lifted off them. We could tell the kids, you're not alone, mommy's always with you, but now I think after tonight, they actually feel it. They believe it and they feel it, and for that, it's priceless.
Do you remember that movie, that song, My Endless Love?
Yes.
Can you connect that with your wife?
Yes.
Because I keep hearing that being played over and over and over. And she says, I know it wasn't easy. She says, but I want to thank you for standing by me and always making me feel safe and never making me feel that there was something wrong with me.
My dad needed to hear that. It was really good for him. My dad did everything she could have asked for, and he found out tonight that she appreciates and thanks him.
After this reading, I feel a lot more at peace. I really feel that Theresa set our family, not only for me and not only for the children, but as a family, set us all in a place where we could be happy.
Whether spirit speaks to one person or the entire family, the message is healing the entire family. I always find it interesting how spirit leads me to the person that needs to hear the message the most. Spirit totally guided me to Andrew.
I really didn't expect much. I feel relieved after hearing from my mom. I'm actually in a great mood. The twins look happy. My dad's happy. I'm glad I came tonight in the end.
I also want to talk about the husband that's departed. Is that your husband?
My name is Kelly, and I'm from Queens, New York. I came to this group reading tonight to connect with my husband somehow, and I just wanted to know that, you know, he's there and that I'm not crazy when I feel him near me.
He goes, oh, he goes, this is my chance. He goes, and if I don't come through, I'm never gonna hear the end of it. I said, yeah, you and 40 other people.
Yeah. My husband, Don, was the nicest person that you would ever meet. Don was my entire family. We were only married just under 5 years. He died 3 months before our 5-year anniversary. There's not a second I don't miss him or a second that I don't, you know, think about him.
But did your husband die quickly?
Yes.
Because he actually just made me feel like I just collapsed and died.
Uh-huh.
But he made me feel like he did take care of himself.
You
understand that? He goes, I went to the doctor. Nobody picked up on it.
My husband, Don, passed away 3.5 years ago from a sudden heart attack. He was actually working a volunteer at a pet store, like a pet rescue place. That's how much he loved animals. And that's where he collapsed and had his heart attack. And it was on his one day off from being an EMT. He was a paramedic the rest of the week. So that's the kind of person he was.
But was this something that he had for a long time? It was born with once they did?
Yeah, but there was no symptoms of it.
What he showed me was a heart with a hole in it, which is just my symbol for that someone is born with some type of heart defect or some type of disorder that has never been detected.
That's exactly what it was.
Nobody knew.
Nobody knew because he didn't have a relationship with his dad, and his dad never told him that
he had heart issues.
Yeah. There were absolutely no signs of my husband's heart condition. He didn't know his medical background, and he was pretty much just, you know, a walking time bomb, and he had no idea this was coming.
After he died, did you have that dream? Because he said, I did come to her after I died, and that we did get to say goodbye.
I dream about Dawn all the time. When Theresa told me that I actually did say goodbye in a different way, that kind of was one of the things that solidified this for me and made it such a great experience, because I think she's right. I did say goodbye to him, and it just wasn't in the way that I expected to.
Spirit did a phenomenal job tonight of really validating for us that they are still with us, and more importantly, that there truly is more to life. I want to thank you all for coming, and may God bless each and every one of you. Thank you.